Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel, and instead of doing my usual stick of telling you how much I've lost, my next goal, and all that fun stuff, I thought I'd do a couple fun videos before we get back into the groove of things. So I'm going to give you a haul video of all the things that we bought in Disney / Universal. Now, cool thing is, we did not buy a whole bunch of things in Disney, but I'm going to show you some of the awesome things that we bought. First thing, my husband and I are both Zootopia fans, and we went around the parks looking for Zootopia things. Disappointed, didn't find much, till we found this. And that's totally worth it. We found this cute figurine set, and they may end up on a shelf together. They may actually end up on a little bit of separate, and we paid about 25 bucks for this baby, a little bit over that with tax. So, super fun, loved it, and we're both huge Zootopia fans. Next thing I bought is actually this little Sully keychain. I spent the whole week debating it because look at this guy. Isn't he just so adorable? And he's blue, and he reminds me of Ravenclaw, and I don't know why. But look at his cute face. Super cute. The next thing we kind of didn't really buy, but they gave it to us, were these, when we went to one of the snack stands, they gave us Mickey Mouse Crazy Straws. We got one in yellow, and we got one in green. We'll totally use these. Super excited about them. Super adorable. That is the end of our Disney haul. See, I told you, didn't have a whole bunch of Disney stuff. Not that we don't like Disney. We love Disney. Just didn't buy a lot because I think we're both holding out for Universal. So I'm going to show you something that is not Harry Potter related because most of our purchases are Harry Potter related. I bought this cute little unicorn from Despicable Me keychain. If you remember, it's so fluffy. My husband actually has a backpack version of this, and I was thinking about turning this into a Christmas ornament for him because we have a running joke, not really a joke, but I call him the Unicorn Man because he is amazing and one of a kind, and this derpy unicorn makes my life. And I got him the backpack version. The next thing I'm going to share with you is actually food-related Harry Potter items. So my husband and I both got a chocolate frog. I'm going to show you one. These things are expensive, but I heard they're your solid chocolate, and they have the wizard card in it. I'm hoping that we get at least one Ravenclaw card, but I don't know if we will. The next one you will probably see in another video. My husband has never ever tried Everflavor beans, and when I was trying to explain to him that just like the books, it is every flavor, earwax, dirt, vomit, and he was like, is there a guide? And I was like, I don't think so. So we're gonna totally do one of those great videos. I think it will be super funny to watch my husband's reaction to the disgusting flavors. And by the way, his least favorite flavor in regular jelly beans is the pear one. He thinks it tastes disgusting. So if he thinks that's disgusting, I'm feeling like he's gonna be miserable. But he'll probably really enjoy it and have fun with me. We also did Butterbeer. So we got the mug, the souvenir mug with it, and we really like them, and cool thing about these is they're hand wash only. Yay! But we are super excited about them. Now that I've tried real Butterbeer and tried the slushy version and the regular version, didn't get to try the hot, I think that I now know what everybody's talking about, because all those knockoff flavor like ones taste nothing like it. Those tasted like pure sugar to me. This didn't taste as sweet as they made it out. It was still sweet, but it wasn't like rot your teeth sweet. the other food related item we got was we got the ice cream cup, souvenir ice cream cup. My husband likes souvenir cups and stuff like that. So he ended up getting this. If you go there, the two flavors of ice cream I would absolutely tell you to try is the chocolate chili, which is not overpoweringly spicy. Like, it's more of like a subtle chocolate, and then it has this like throat burn a little bit. And it's just like has an after punch. Not super terrible, but if you don't like spicy, don't even bother. My other flavor I'm going to tell you to get is an Earl Grey lavender. Super good. It tasted like a lavender London fog. Loved it. Thought it was delicious. Was fantastic. Loved it. It was really good. And the next thing I'm going to show you is we got ourselves wands. Of course we did. So I'm going to show you my husband's wand. Now we each got an unclaimed wand. So this is my husband's unclaimed wand. Cool thing about it, the packaging is really awesome. And they give you a little black bag to put it in, and that is just super cute. So you see people walking around with these, and you're just like, oh, they got a wand. And it was really fun. So you can do awesome about this. It's an interactive wand. Gets to go through the park and do all sorts of magic. And it comes with this beautiful little map here that has the Diagon and Hogsmeade like map on it. And it shows you where you can do all your magic. So much fun. Love doing magic. Felt like I was there and I got to do it. So anyways, this is my husband's wand. And he got one that described him. One of the biggest qualities of a holly wand is healing powers, and just my husband's just very natured in that way and very, very awesome. So this is the wand. It is super cool. Both me and my husband had a similar experience, and I'll tell you what it is. When I picked up my wand, I knew that it was my wand, and I like, when the guy told me the description, my husband looks at me and goes, yep, that's you. And I was like, yeah, this feels like my wand. And I had picked up a couple other wands because I just like the aesthetic of them. But when I picked up my wand, I was like, this is my wand. This is totally me. So husband was a holly. Healing powers. My wand is this beautiful little lady right here, and it was a ivy wand. And one of the main qualities of an ivy wand is hardworking and determined and stubborn. So definitely me. I was super excited about it. Really cool, super delicate, very beautiful. Love the little gold ball at the end of it. And love doing magic everywhere. Like, I got really good at it. When you like, yeah, super pretty. Love this wand. Very excited about it. The next thing is our third wand. My husband really kept looking at Nifidorotog's wand the whole entire time we were there. And so then he was like, do you think I could buy it? You know, I was like, if you really want it, go for it. But he just really loved it. I think that is beautiful, and I think that super beautiful wand. Super, it's interactive as well, so when we go back to the parks, he now has a choice of what wand he would like. If they do ever bring the Fantastic Beasts wands, I already know that I'm going to be purchasing one. I really like the Madam President of wand, and if you have not seen it, super cute. Maybe I'll put a picture in. Has a little pink purpley gem at the bottom of it. The next thing I bought was some Hogwarts Ravenclaw gear. So I've seen these before. Super cool. I thought I could not live without one, so I got myself a headgirl pin. Can't wait to put it on my cloak and totally rock it the next Harry Potter event I go to. Next thing I got is actually something my husband bought for me for my birthday. Love it. It is a Ravenclaw hoodie, super soft on the inside, has this beautiful embroidered and painted raven here. Super pretty. The other really cool feature of this is actually that it has Ravenclaw written on the sleeve. So super soft. Cannot wait for fall season to actually get here. It is hot, so I can wear this. The last thing we got actually has a story with it. So I had been debating getting something, and I was not sure if I wanted it because I was like, oh, I don't need it. And then I decided I needed it, but I decided a little too late that I needed it. And because they have their Fright Night over on the Universal side and they close at 5, I almost couldn't get it. So on my birthday, on Saturday, our last day at the park, I decided I wanted something, so we went looking around the park and some of their stores, seeing if I could find it, and I just couldn't find it anywhere, and I was getting really sad. So we went to Hogsmeade, and we went into one of the stores, and I was just like, I'll just ask, because maybe they have one in the back, and it's just not up front right now. I wanted a giant Pygmy Puff, and I'm happy to say that I got one. I'm super, super soft. It is pink and adorable. I don't know if the color will actually come through nicely, but very cute. So love it. So soft. So squidgy. I named it Tweaks. So shout out to those who were working and saw. I mean, all I did was ask a question, and they totally, they said, oh, I don't think we have one here. They actually went to Diagon Alley, grabbed me one from stock, brought it over to Hogsmeade so that I could have it. If that's not above and beyond, then I don't know what it is. Because I couldn't go over because of the Fright Night, and I need a special ticket for that. So, seriously, you guys are awesome. I can't even say thank you enough. So cool. And thank you so much for my Pygmy Puff. And so they got me one and brought it over. And now I have myself a Pygmy Puff. And it'll probably stay in the background of this video for some of the videos, my future videos, next to Oswald my owl. But super cute. I just love the little feetsies on this little guy. He's got four. So excited. But that's all I got from Universal and Disney, and I had such a great time. In another video, I will talk about my successes in Universal and Disney and the amazing things I learned and some rides that I might want to give a little warning about in the future. But I can't wait for next year, because my husband and I decided we are probably going back so we can do and have fun and experience the magic all over again. So, cannot wait. Super excited. And I hope you enjoyed my haul. And like and subscribe. And tell me what your favorite item that I purchased is. Or if you've been there recently, what you got. I would love to hear it. Disney / or Universal, if you got some cute stuff at Disney. By the way, they have some killer cute shirts at Disney, and I debated them. I just couldn't justify spending $36 on a t-shirt. That's probably why I didn't spend as much money. But anyways, thank you for being here, and tune in to the next couple videos. I will be showcasing some of my outfits and also some things that I learned. All right. Love you all. Have a great day.